said that I have opportunity to welcome our the chief or the man behind all the quality care positions in India, Dr. Giridhar Vyadi. What is the quality care in medicine? And care of the patients. And many of ourselves, I am old timer, I have studied medicine, I have completed MBBS 1967 or 68, MD in 72. After I went to United States, and we never bother about what is the quality, we never talked about the quality care those days, you know. And when we came back and started this quality medical center, we tried to talk about the medical auditing, you know, medical auditing in our hospital. The biggest challenge is from the doctors. Who are you to check my credit, and who are you to check my way of functioning? Who are you to look at my papers, whether I am doing right or wrong? We have a big fight, and on that day itself, I got that idea of medical audit in our hospital in 1997, and we stopped that topic completely. Then I am not able to introduce how to check whether our doctors are doing right or wrong, whether our type of treatment is right or wrong. We have a tough time. And God's sake, Giridhar Vyadi came and started that NABH accreditation. Only those period, of that period only, we are able to do something about. And this side of India, at least we're talking about what is the quality care, what is the standardized of care, how we have to run the hospital. You know, that is the biggest challenge. In previous years, we didn't have any kind of norms or any kind of guidance how to run the hospital. And Dr. Bhaktavatsala knows about it. He has said, before me, he came here from United States, tried to do best of things in Coimbatore. He always says he is guided for me in Coimbatore because he did everything here before I came. And at the end of the day, we cannot enforce any of rules and regulations in the hospital. Our doctors are, you know, our bosses in medical schools, I am the ambassador, don't ask any question. This is what we have done. We ran the medical services in those days. Only now, after the Quality Council of India, that rules and regulation came, and we are doing something about the quality care in India. Especially because of the NABH accreditation, there are many hospitals. I am very happy that under the guidance of Mr. Vyadi, NABH accreditation hospital, we have 3,640 NABH hospitals are here now. That is a great achievement. And JCI accreditation is about 38. We are now only introducing some kind of streamlining operations in the hospital, how the building should be, how the infrastructure should be, how we have to maintain the basics of maintenance of the hospital, including the pollutions, etc., medical investment, disposables, how to take care of the patients, and all are happening only now. Because the Quality Council of India started doing something in India. I am really proud that our special guest, our Giridhar Vyadi, is here. And he is spearing the torch to make sure that India is is giving right kind of health care to our citizens of India. That is all about it, sir. We have so many medical schools, medical colleges, and all are happening, but still we have a problem of standardizing the care for our patients and how the patient care should be, how the protection of the patient should be. All are in the avenue of the NIMH guidelines. And I am very glad that there are so many new guidelines. Every 3 years the guidelines are changing, and he is making sure India is delivering right kind of care to our patients. Problem of our education and our hospital setup is that still we have to go a long way to give a quality care in India, especially ethical care in India. How we are practicing in India, all are changing slowly. Slowly we are changing into right kind of path. We are getting better and better. And at the end of the day, 75% of the care for our patients are from the private care, private hospitals. Only the 20-25% are by the public care. And hospitals, those hospitals are giving free treatment. Our hospitals are our 75% of our patients are getting treatment and paying for the treatment from the pocket. The insurance system, etc., is not widely available like Western countries. Many of we, our population may not know that health and education is the responsibility of the government. Again and again I tell you this responsibility about, and the good care should be given by the public hospitals, not the private hospitals. Private hospital always costly. That is no, you cannot demand that. When you go to the 5-star hotel, the tea is 300 rupees, this SNC hotel. When you go to the street, you get the tea for 5 rupees, you know. The private hospital can charge anything whatever they want, because that is their property, they are doing things. You have no right to question. This is my view. Now, I don't know about the other view, this is my view. You, yes, yes, citizen of India, you have right to ask your legislature, MPs, ministers, that you give me proper health care to me. That is each and every citizen's right. But we are not able to do it because of the, now our governments are mainly looking at the creating the infrastructure, etc., to improve the quality of life for India. Then automatically the quality of care should go up. That is what their view. Now, the present, I'm very happy that our Prime Minister Narendra Modi started this Ayushman program. And Ayushman program, you all know, that is 5 lakh rupees per family. And I hope that will extend to other areas also. In our states, we give the CM's relief fund, CM Kati, we are all having it. In course of time, we may get the reasonable, good support from the governments to treat all citizens of India, That's all about it. And by the way, these quality institutions, quality care, supervise, or see you over the shoulder there whether you are doing right or wrong. That kind of things will happen. And I'm very happy that things are going well. Only private insurance in our hospital, I don't know about the KG. About 10 or 20% of the patients are taken care of by insurances. All other is only by pockets. They will give from the pocket. This is a very unusual anywhere in the world. Anywhere, nothing is happening like this. And I am happy that we in India are now entering into a new phase of life, especially in the healthcare. But whatever available in the world, in the medical care, in the United States or UK or anywhere in the world, or Japan, Korea, anywhere in the world, all type of treatment facilities available in India, thanks to the effort of the private medical situation, medical organizations like Apollo, etc. Whatever available in America, we are having it. But whether this type of availability to each and every citizen of India, that's what all about it, you know. That is the biggest challenge we have. We have 1.2 billion people. How we are going to take care of this many population with this many, the wide variation, 0 to 100. 0 to 100% variation, not one simple variation. And in this type of anomaly, nowhere in the country, nowhere in the world. I hope in course of time, all citizens of India should get reasonable good health care with the standardized care, as a very quality care is everywhere, quality situation should be there, and the quality care should be available for the all citizens of India at affordable cost. That is all about it. And hope the present new government, the new Modi's government, will help the poor to get the right kind of treatment. For example, my friend KTP only, because every day we are seeing, every day accident, everywhere that many people cannot pay. We always say, if there is no pay, you go to the government hospital. Go to the government hospital. At the end of the day, government hospital, whether the patient will survive or not, that is our next question. These are the anomalies we are all facing it. I think these anomalies will be taken care of by the present empowered government, and hope so we will all be okay. And with the able guidance of our president and the Mr. Gilde Rayani, all will help us in giving our citizens good standard care to all of our Indian people. Thanks for giving me opportunity.